One of my favorite principles that Carl Sagan talks about, and something that I use in my daily life all the time, is to come up with multiple working hypotheses for some claim. Come up with an alternative explanation. Whether it's something you believe or don't believe, it's something you heard for the first time, this is one of the most important habits of mine you can do. And I've seen this in executive rooms. I've seen it in debates within government, on campuses. Those that are immediately thinking of alternative explanations to what they're seeing are some of, they really turn out to be the leaders of the world. And we want you to be leaders. I want this class to be the leaders of the next generation. So these, I just want to give you one example of how you can practice sort of multiple working hypotheses, coming up with alternative hypotheses. This was a paper that Carl and colleagues of ours wrote around gender bias in academics. And just to give you a sense of how we get rewarded in academics, it's generally through citations. So if I write a paper and I get cited, that sort of looks good to my dean. I can get funding. I can get promoted. It's a little cynical. It's a little bit oversimplified. There's a lot more to the reward system. But let's simplify it to that. So more citations, more money. Is there a difference between men self-citations and women self-citations? Because when we cite, we have the opportunity in academics to self-cite. Are women doing it more, or men doing it more, or is it a parity? This little dashed line right there represents parity. So if men and women were self-citing over the last 50 years the same, then they would be right on this line. As you can see, men self-cite more by about 60 or 70% over a long period of time. We checked this on various fields. We did all sorts of cross-cutting of the data, from sociology to education to philosophy to math to history. Men self-cite themselves far more than women. So we wrote a paper, we posted it on the archive, and we wanted to have some sort of explanation. Now, this is one possible explanation to it. Men are just simply jerks, or more confident, or overconfident in themselves. Now, this aspect of this particular story got picked up by social media news and spread like wildfire. And this was the explanation that was given in the headlines. They didn't look at the rest of the paper where we sat down and spent hours and hours and days coming up with multiple explanations to what we were seeing in the data. So it's your turn. You probably, no one's read the paper, so I think we're okay here. Take 2 minutes, turn to your partner, and come up with some other alternative explanations why we would see men self-citing more than women in the literature over the last 50 or 60 years. Go to work. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to have to interrupt. I hear great discussion. So I'm guessing, let me just guess for a second. You guys got more than just men are jerks, even though they men can be jerks. This is for sure. Who wants to be courageous again and give me an explanation? Yes? Awesome. Perfect. Yes, this is one that is actually...
Why don't you repeat the answer?
Oh, yeah, so I'll repeat the answer because they won't hear this on video. So the explanation is that there's more men in academia and has been for hundreds of years, absolutely right, and that they'll have more targets, essentially, when they self-cite because they have more papers and there's more men. Wonderful. That's a great alternative explanation. Perfect. What else? There's others. That's very interesting. Another great explanation. So this one is that men have been in the field longer. They tend to be the PIs or the principal investigators running the lab. They have the chance to sort of establish themselves. So when they sort of look to self-cite, maybe that is the area, that is the individual or the paper because of that expertise. Good. Excellent. Let's do one more. I saw another hand. Yes. That's right. So it goes along with the first example that because there might be various reasons why women might leave academia earlier, they don't get the papers, they might retire, they just don't have, again, as many targets. So that's great. You guys are good at this. Now, it's anything. It doesn't have to be this. If we had time, I have many other examples. I'd want you to test your ability to create alternative explanations.